Speleology Sundays at Bluff Dweller's Cave. Speleothem Spectrum. What is that color?
I'm standing here in Bluff Dweller's Cave, and if you look behind me, you'll see the cave coral and some beautiful flowstone and draperies, and you'll notice the different colors.
During a cave tour, you may see the bright white, the orangish colors, the brown colors, the rusty colors, and wonder where those colors came from. Many decades ago, people saw it was rusty colored and assumed that means it was iron oxide. You know, rust. But after geochemical testing was done by a speleologist, it was determined it wasn't rust at all. Well, at least not in most cases that you're used to seeing. Usually this coloration is due to humic and fulvic acids. It's actually formed in the soil and comes through with the water as it moves to the cave. Will White of Penn State did this research back in the late 70s and 80s.
So, why did we think it was iron oxide in the past? Well, it's a fair assumption. Before there was geochemical testing, it looks orangey-brown. It looks rusty, like iron oxide. But testing has told us better. So now that we know better, we share that better information.
There are many things that are the same color. Here's a good example. These salamanders are bright orange. Are they made of oranges?
I can assure you, I don't even know what an orange is. I live in a cave.
After saying it for many decades, it's hard for people to get used to not saying iron oxide. Now, there are some speleothems that have iron oxide. There's all sorts of different colors that can be caused by different trace impurities, but most of the speleothems, that brownish-reddish hue, it's due to the humic and fulvic substances. And the layering that goes from lighter color to darker color can be due to changes in the surface and how the water's picking up those substances.
These beautiful speleothems in Luray, their draperies are some of the best. I went there in 2011 and took this picture. Doesn't it look like a towel hung out to dry? And those alternating dark and light layers, those are the humic fulvic acids. Thank you so much for learning with me today. Bluff Dweller's Cave is open 7 days a week, 362 days a year. So come on by for a tour and maybe we'll teach you something. If you really like learning about cave minerals and speleothems, I highly recommend the book Cave Minerals of the World by Hill and Forte. You can buy it at the National Speleological Society bookstore.